Hi friends, in this tutorial series we are implementing an online e-commerce website using Spring Boot and Angular 8. In today's tutorial we will be implementing the book shopping module using which the user he can browse the books and if he wants to buy the book he can add it to the shopping cart. In the next tutorial we will be implementing the shopping cart functionality. This is the final e-commerce website that we will be developing and this is the shop book module that we will be developing today. Here the user can view all the books available that he can buy. Currently here he can see only 2 books, but if you are an admin you can go to books and you can add more books here. So currently here there are only 2 books. By clicking on the add new book you can add more books here. So we have already implemented the books and the users admin module. So the user he can browse the books and if he is interested in buying a book he will need to click on add to cart. So once he has clicked on this add to cart then it will get added to the cart here. He can view the book that has been added to the cart and also the price of the book. Once he clicks on view cart then he will be taken to the cart where he will be shown the final bill and also the contents of the cart. So the cart functionality we will be implementing it later. Today we are just implementing this book shopping module. For this I will be taking reference of my website javainews.com. So go to full stack tutorials. You go to e-commerce website online bookstore using Angular 8 and Spring Boot. The tutorial that we will be implementing today is e-commerce website online bookstore create book shopping module. I'll be sharing this URL along with the YouTube video. In this tutorial series, we'll be developing an e-commerce website for buying books. In previous tutorial, we had created the book admin module to edit existing book details. You can go to this tutorial here. So here I've given the video tutorial here and uploaded to YouTube. You can go through this. Also, the source code for this tutorial I have shared below. We'll be modifying this source code for this tutorial. So here we have the Spring Boot code and the Angular code. Download both the Spring Boot code as well as the Angular code. The Spring Boot code, it is a Maven project, so import it in Eclipse and go to pom.xml and run the command maven install. Similarly, the Angular code, import it in Microsoft Visual Studio Code and go to the location where you have downloaded the source code and here run the command npm install. This will download all the dependencies that are required for this project. Once this is done, run the command ngserve to start the Angular project. Also go to the Spring Boot project and start it. So here go to source main Java e-commerce application and run this as a Java application. So both our Spring Boot as well as Angular project have started. If you now go to localhost 4200, here we can see the admin module that we had created previously. So we had created the users module. Currently we have only a single user and the books module. So currently we have 3 books. So we'll be making use of this book list to implement the book shopping module. Since in the Spring Boot module we have already implemented the controller to return us the list of existing books, all the changes that are required for this module will be at the Angular end. So let us begin with the implementation part. We'll be creating a new component named shopbook. So the command is ng generate component shopbook. So go to the Angular project and use this command. So here the component is created for us. If you go to the Microsoft Visual Studio Code, you go to source app and here a new component, you can see it has been created. Next in the app routing module, we'll be adding a path for the shopbook component that we just created. So copy this path here. So for the URL slash shop, we'll be showing the shopbook component. Go to the Angular project. So go to the app routing module. We will be adding one more path. It will be the path will be shop and it will be for the shopbook component. Import this here. Next in the menu component HTML file, we'll be adding the menu option to show the shopbook component that we just created. So here we have the unordered list where we are showing the various menu items. Here we'll be adding one more list item. It will be having the router link of slash shop which we have defined here. So copy this. Go to the menu component. Go to the HTML file. And here the UL list. If you now go to localhost 4200, so here we can see that along with the admin, we also have the shop here. Click on shop and here we can see shopbook works. So our shopbook component, it is working properly. Next, we'll be modifying the shopbook component to display the list of books to the user. We'll be modifying first the shopbook component TypeScript file. So in the TypeScript file in the constructor, we'll be passing the router and the HTTP client service. The router will be making use of it later to navigate to the cart component. The HTTP client service will be using it to retrieve the list of books. So we have in the HTTP client service we have already defined the get books which retrieves the list of books by calling the Spring Boot backend. In the ng onInit method, we'll be making use of the HTTP client service getBooks method to get the list of books. The response that we get, we'll be passing it to the handleSuccessfulResponse method here. The list of books response that we get, we'll be storing it in the books received array that we have defined above here. In this component, we want to display the books details to the user. The book data that we receive from the backend, it has the image bytes in the pick byte field. But in order to display this image before these bytes, we need to append data colon image slash jpeg semicolon base64 to the pick bytes. Only then the image it will get displayed correctly in the HTML page. So in the book model class, we have already defined the retrieved image field. So for the array of books that we receive from the backend, that is books received, we'll be iterating it. Then during the iteration, we'll be creating a new book. And for this new book, we'll be defining the retrieved image field, where we'll be appending the required string to the book.pickbyte and then storing it in the retrieved image. Later, we'll be storing this book or pushing this book in the books array that we have defined above. So this books array will then be using for displaying the image and other details in the UI. When we had implemented the ViewBook admin module, we had made similar changes to display the book image. So let us make this change for the ShopBook component file. Go to the ShopBook component types file. Import the required classes. We will import the router and the HTTP client service. Next, we'll be modifying the ShopBook component HTML file to display the list of books using the Bootstrap card CSS. So card CSS, it is a flexible and extensible content container. It includes the options for headers and footers and a wide variety of content, contextual background, colors, and powerful display options. So we'll be making use of this card container. In the HTML file, we define the div class as container row. So this container row, it is provided to us by Bootstrap. And what it does is that it divides the complete HTML page into 12 equal columns. So we can make use of the columns as required. So for example, here, if we define column hyphen empty hyphen 4, it means that out of the 12 columns, we want to make use of 4 columns. In the second div, we iterate over the list of books that we have defined in the TypeScript file. Also here, we have defined the class as call hyphen md hyphen 4. So each book, it will take 4 columns. So in a single row, we will be able to show 3 books. The fourth book, it will be displayed in the second row then. Then using the card container, we display the book details. Also here, the card block, it is used to add some additional padding to the card container. So let us make these changes. Copy this HTML file. Go to the ShopBook component HTML file. Paste it here. If we go to localhost 4200 and click on shop here, then we can see the list of books which the user can see. He can see the book name, the price, as well as the author. Also, if he wants to add the book to the cart, he will have to click on the add to cart button here. We have to still implement this functionality, but when he will be clicking on this add to cart, the book will be added to the shopping cart. Next, we'll be adding the add to cart functionality. So whenever the user, he wants to buy any book, suppose he wants to buy this The Godfather book, we'll be clicking on add to cart button and then this book, it will get added to the cart. We'll first be modifying the book model class. In this class, we'll be adding another field is added. This field will be used to identify if a book has been added to a shopping cart or not. So this will be a field of type boolean. If is added is true, it means that this particular book, it has been added to the cart. If it is false, it means that it has not been added to the cart. So let us add this field. Go to model, book, and here add this field. Next, we'll be implementing add book to cart functionality. For this, we'll be making use of local storage. So web storage objects, local storage and session storage allow us to save key value pairs in the browser. What is interesting about them is that data survives page refresh in case of session storage, whereas in case of local storage, even a full browser restart, the data will not get lost. We'll be modifying the ShopBook component TypeScript file. First, we'll be creating a variable named cartBooks. It will hold the details of the books added to the cart. Then in the ngOnInit method, from the local storage, we retrieve the item named cart. So initially, we have not created any item named cart in the local storage. So this data, it will be null. So here we check if data, it is not equal to null, then whatever is there that we have retrieved from the local storage, we first pass it to a JavaScript object and then assign it to the cartBooks variable that we have defined above here. Else we initialize the cartBooks variable to empty. So whenever the ShopBooks component page, it gets loaded for the first time, this data, it will be null. So this cartBooks, it will be initialized to empty, which means that no books have been added to the cart. Later when the user, he clicks on the add to cart button, the add to cart function will get called, and the book ID of the book which is to be added to the cart is passed to this function. Using the book ID, we retrieve the book which is to be added to the cart from the books array. So here we get the book which is to be added to the cart. Next, we declare a variable named cart data and initialize it as empty. Using the local storage, we again try to retrieve the item named as cart, and we check if it is not equal to null, then we pass it to JSON object and assign it to the cart data. In our case, as the user, he has first time clicked on the add to cart button, so still there will be no item named cart in the local storage. So the cart data, it will not be assigned to this JSON.pass data and it will still be empty. To this empty cart data, we then push the book which is to be added to the cart. We then call the this.updateCartData method with the cart data passed as the argument. And in this updateCartData method, we assign the cart books variable that we have defined above to the cart data. So this cart data, it contains the details of the book which have been added to the cart. So this has then now been assigned to cart books. Next, in the local storage, we set the item as cart and the value as the cart data, which contains the book details to be added to the cart. So here we first convert this JSON object to string and then store it with the key as cart. Finally, we set the isAdded field of the book which is added to the cart to true. So now one book has been added to the cart. Now suppose this page gets loaded again. Then here in the ngOnInit method, this time from the local storage, we will be getting the item named cart. So this data, this time it will not be null. So we'll be passing a JSON object from this data and assigning it to the cart books. Similarly, if the user again clicks on the add to cart button, then the add to cart function will get called along with the book ID which is to be added. And this time when we do local storage.getItemCart, it will not return us a null, and the cart data will be assigned the JSON object that we get from this data. So the cart data, it will hold the JSON object which contains the book details of the first book that has been added to the cart. We'll then be pushing the second book that is to be added to the cart data. So this cart data will now hold two books, and then this cart data will again be storing in the local storage as cart. So if the user, he again clicks on add to cart button, then the third book will be pushed to our cart data. We have already seen this update cart data method. The go to cart method, it will be used to navigate to the cart component. So we'll be needing this in the next tutorial. And finally, here we have the empty cart method. Whenever this method gets called, it means that the shopping cart, it needs to be emptied. So we'll be assigning the cart books to empty, and also the local storage will be clearing it of all the data. So let us make these changes to the shopbook component TypeScript file. First, I'll be creating the variable named cart books. So go to the shopbook component TypeScript file, and here I'll be assigning the variable. Next, we'll be adding this for local storage in the ngOnInit method. Finally, we'll be finding the methods that we have created here. Next, we'll be modifying the shopbook component HTML file to display the add to shopping cart functionality. So here in the HTML file, we'll again be defining the class as container row. So we'll be getting 12 columns. In the first two columns, we'll be showing the title as books. Then we have the next 10 columns here. So in the next 10 columns, we offset the first 8 columns, and in the remaining 2 columns, we'll be displaying the shopping cart. The shopping cart, it will be a drop down, and when the user he clicks on it, we'll be able to see the details of the books that have been added to the cart. We'll be iterating the cart books variable that we had defined in the TypeScript file and which holds the books that have been added to the shopping cart. So here we'll be iterating over the cart books, and we'll be displaying the details such as name, price. Also here we'll be showing 2 buttons. One will be the go to cart button and the other will be the empty cart. So the empty cart button will be showing it only if there are items in the cart books. So it means that some items are present in the shopping cart, else will not be showing this empty cart button. The go to cart button will be making use to navigate to the cart component. We'll be making use of it mostly in the next tutorial. And here in the component HTML file, we have the code that we had created previously. We'll just be making one change to this code. Here we'll also be adding disabled is equal to true if book dot is added is also true. So let us first make this change. So go to the HTML file, and here for the add to cart button, add this. So for a particular book, if the user he clicks on the add to cart button, then this button, it will become disabled, which means that the book, it has already been added to the cart. Let us make the other changes. So copy this div container that we have defined above and paste this above this container row. If you now go to localhost 4200 and click on shop, so as before we can see the list of books. Also here we can see books added in cart as 0. So currently there are no books added, and we can see just the view cart button. If we now click on add to cart button here and also add to cart button for this book, here we can see that 2 books have been added to the cart, and these are the names of the books and their price. Also now we can see the empty cart button here. So if we click on empty cart, this cart, it will become empty. In the next tutorial, we'll be implementing the shopping cart component. Hope you have understood this tutorial. You can download the source code from here. Thank you.